Hello everyone. Now that we are conversant with Outseal Studio layout, let us take on the available instruction groups, starting with the bit instructions. For practical demonstration in this video and the next, set up the connections with the circuit diagram on the screen. An Arduino Nano on an adapter board, a PC817 Opto Isolator model, a relay model, two push button switches, an indicator, and a power supply. Bit instructions have only two possible values, which are true or false. Their data sources could either be digital inputs represented by variables S.1 to S.8 for Arduino Nano, digital outputs represented by variables R0.1 to R0.8, internal memory bits from variables B.1 to B.256, and status bits for timers and counters. Let's consider the first of these bit instructions, contacts or switches. Contacts or switches are normally open contacts, NO, and normally closed contacts, NC. They are input instructions in a ladder diagram. Their data source could either be from a digital input variable, digital output variable, input memory bits, and status bits of timers or counters. When the input source of a normally open contact is true, the output condition will become true. On the other hand, when the input source of the normally closed contact is true, the output condition will become false. The reverse is the case when the input source is false. Let us visualize this in simulation mode. Drag a normally open contact into the program with data source S.1. Then, click on Simulation from the mode menu and observe that the rung up to the contact changed from black to green. On the basic simulation window, under Input, click on the first button that corresponds to 01 in slot 0 to change the contact state to true. Observe that the button color changes to blue, the contact color changes to orange, and the rest of the rung is now green. Another click on the button will change the contact state to false, thereby returning the rung condition to its previous state. Now, right-click on the contact and select Turn into Normally Close. Go to simulation mode and observe that the rung condition is already green when the input state of the contact is false. Change the state of the contact to true by clicking on the button on 01, slot 0, under input of the simulation window. Observe that the contact color is now orange and the rung color has changed to black. It can be seen that the normally closed contact action is in reverse to that of the normally opened contact. Output instructions send the condition of a rung to an output or internal memory variable bit. They are normal coil, inverse coil, latched coil, unlatched coil, flip on rising, and flip on falling. A normal coil variable bit will be true when the rung condition is true. For an inverse coil, its variable bit will be true when the rung condition is false. The reverse is the case when the rung condition is false. In Outseal Studio, you can place more than one coil either in series or in parallel to respond to the same rung condition. To simulate these instructions, drag a normal coil to the rung that has a normally open contact. Drag variable R0.1 to the normal coil. In simulation mode, change the contact state to true. Observe that when the rung condition is green, the coil also becomes green. Button 01, slot 0, under the output section on the simulation window changes to orange, confirming its true state. while ensuring that your Arduino Nano is plugged into the USB port of your computer, go back to Design Mode and to the Settings menu. You can give the project any name you want. Then select Nano V5 Hardware and the Nano port. Exit the Settings window and click on Send on the code menu. You should be prompted with Upload Succeeded. Now click on Online Mode and show the Live Data window. Observe that the TX LED on the Nano is flashing to indicate online mode communication. Hold down the push button switch connected to input S.1 of the Nano. The indicator connected to output R.1 should come on. Observe that the run condition in Outseal Studio becomes true and R.1 coil changes color to green. On the live data window, the rightmost bit of group R1, column 16, which represents the coil state, is now 1. The rightmost bit of group S1, column 16, representing the contact, is also 1. Release the switch and see that the bit changes to 0. Return to design mode. Right-click on the coil and select Turn into Output Not. In simulation mode, when the contact state is false, the inverse coil state is true, signified by the green color of the coil and the orange color of this button. Change the state of the contact to true and observe that the coil variable bit is now false. Upload the code to the Nano and notice that the indicator is on. Go to online mode. See that R.1 coil is green and the live data bit is 1. Hold down the push button switch. Observe a reversal in the state of the indicator and R.1 data in Outseal Studio. We will continue with the other bit instructions in the next video. If you found this video helpful, please click on the like button, the subscribe button, and the notification bell to keep receiving content from this channel. Let me know what you think about this video in the comment section. See you in the next video.